over the world. I'm here again. My name is Apostle Ben Okoye, and I have a word from the Lord for you tonight. I want you to brace up for this word because it's going to change your life and it's going to turn you into a champion. In the book of Mark chapter 5 verse 35, there's a story of a particular man who came to Jesus to tell Jesus that his daughter is dead. In fact, that his daughter is sick and at the point of death. And the Bible says that while this man came to Jesus and was telling Jesus that, please, can you come to my house? That my daughter is sick. I need you to come and pray for her so that she can be healed. News came to him from his servants that his daughter is dead. Hallelujah. And Jesus said to him, you know, there is something that touched me in that particular scripture. The people that came to him said, why bother the teacher? Why are you bothering Jesus to come to your house? Your daughter is dead. And Jesus, when he had the conversation, he said, Jairus, do not be afraid. Just believe. These are priceless words from the Son of God to everyone hearing me tonight. He was giving a negative information prior to the information that he was giving Jesus. In fact, he was telling Jesus that, please come and pray for my daughter. My daughter is seriously sick. Then another news came and he was told, your daughter is dead. Why are you bothering the master? Why are you disturbing Jesus? You can see that Jesus does not have time to go and pray for that girl again because the child is dead. There's no need. Jesus, having heard what they were saying, told Jairus. He said, Jairus, do not be afraid. Only believe. I have a word for somebody watching me tonight. The Lord Jesus is saying, I should tell you, do not be afraid, only believe. I do not know what you are passing through, but this word is for somebody that is watching me right now. The Lord said, I should tell you, do not be afraid, only believe. In Matthew chapter 21 verse 22, he said, all things, whatsoever you ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. He said, whatever you desire in prayer, believe it, you will receive it. For all things are possible to him who believes. When the angel visited Mary and told Mary about something which was practically impossible in the eyes of men, how can a woman who had not had sexual intercourse with a man be able to become pregnant and give birth to a child? In the medical parlance, it is impossible. Except for these days when they are now beginning to do some kind of medical research where they can inject a woman with a man's semen and the woman becomes pregnant. But in those days, it was practically impossible. And Mary, being a woman, she looked at the angel and said, angel, this thing you are saying is practically impossible. I'm only betrothed to this man called Joseph. I have not had sexual intercourse with him. And the angel said, the power of the Most High shall come upon you. For all things are possible to him who believes. The Lord said, I should tell you, woman, listening to me right now, fear not, only believe. I don't know how many years you have stayed in childlessness. The Lord said, I should tell you, fear not, only believe. I don't know how many years you stayed in joblessness. You have been searching for a job for many years now. You have put in application in so many companies and yet you are still jobless. The Lord said, I should tell you, fear not, only believe. I don't know how many years you have suffered from that sickness. In fact, you practically live on drugs. The Lord said, I should tell you, fear not, only believe. For if you believe, all things will be possible in your life. I do not know what you are going through. But the Lord said, I shall announce to you tonight that if you can only believe that He can do it, He will do it. This is not just about saying it, it's about believing. This is not just about talking about it, it's about believing. The Lord said that I should tell you tonight that He has heard your prayers and it's about to do a new thing in your life. He said, I should let you know that all things are passed away. Behold, all things are about to become new in your life. He said, I should let you know that that thing you are going through now will not kill you. If you can only believe, you will come out from it a new person. You are coming out from that sickness. You are coming out from that disease. You are coming out from that infirmity. You are coming out from that joblessness. You are coming out from poverty. The Lord said, I shall announce to you today, just like He told Jairus in the Bible. He said, Jairus, do not be afraid, because fear is one of the factors that removes faith from us and makes us helpless and makes the devil to be able to put us in the cage where we are today. Fear is a spirit and it torments so many people today and keeps them in perpetual bondage. But if you can deal with fear tonight and only believe God, everything troubling you tonight will cease troubling you. If you can only believe God tonight, that which you think that is not possible, that which you think that's impossible with men will become possible. God will make it happen for you. As I round up tonight, I speak to you that is listening to me tonight. Every problem that you are going through, financial problem, marital problem, spiritual problem, physical problems, I speak into your life tonight that the Lord God of heaven, whom I serve, will bring an end to that problem in the name of Jesus. The Lord God, whom I serve, will bring an end to that predicament that has troubled your life in the name of Jesus. The Lord will take away everything that is making you cry every night and will give you joy. Listen to me, joy is about to come your way. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we're like men that dream. God is about to turn again your captivity and put a new song in your mouth. I celebrate with you tonight because God has changed your story. I speak into your life that everything that has brought you pain from today will begin to bring you joy. A turnaround is about to happen in your life. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I speak into your life that job which you have been looking for, a miracle is about to happen. A miracle job is about to come your way. Tonight, as you sleep with your husband, everything that is blocking that fallopian tube from receiving that semen, today, it is unbroken. It's unlocked in the name of Jesus. I cause cancer in your life. I cause HIV in your life. I cause diabetes. I cause high blood pressure. I cause every form of sickness that has troubled your life. I cause it tonight in the name of Jesus. You are free. You are free, and you are free indeed. Jesus went to Jairus and dealt with that particular thing. In fact, as I'm speaking to you right now, check yourself. That sickness has gone. That disease has gone. That migraine headache has gone in the name of Jesus. Once again, I want to thank God for your life tonight. I want to bless God for helping you to tune in to this channel. And I hope to see you tomorrow at the same time again. But don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, because every day God brings a new word for you, a word that will change your life forever. As you subscribe and as you watch, God will continually bless you. I want to encourage you to share this with as many that you believe that need the hand of God in their lives. And I believe that these words I have spoken today will change somebody's life forever in the name of Jesus. Till I see you again tomorrow, keep living in the realm of miracles. God bless you.